Hi folks, and welcome to DevTrends. Today we're going to talk about React hooks and HTTP version 3. We can honestly say that React is current gold standard of UI libraries or web frameworks when thinking of it together with follow-up tools. But though React as a development tool has great and powerful functionality, there are still areas which can be a subject to improvements. For example, reusability. Currently, there are two main concepts of how to write and share reusable logic in React: higher order components and render props. But both of them require writing pretty lot of boilerplate code, adding even more overhead of existing wrapper hell, as we and even React team itself call common situation where there are just too many level of components. And most of them are just wrappers, providers, consumers, and other entities which sole purpose is to share a state between children. And here React hooks come in. So React hooks is a new feature of React 16.7, which is currently in alpha and in consideration status, but has already big positive feedback from developers. So what exactly is hook? In terms of React, hook is a special function that lets you to hook into state or lifecycle methods of a function component without writing a class. One of the greatest benefits React hooks provide is that now you can reuse stateful logic among components without changing the hierarchy. You just import a hook, which is a plain function itself, and use it in different places of code where it applies. And now let's see how it works on the first hook React provided, the state hook. For that, let's install React 16.7 and create a small boilerplate. So let's switch to our iTerm. Let's create a new folder. Let's call it hooks demo. Change directory. Let's init a new npm project here. And let's install some dependencies like React. We need next version, as 16.7 is currently in alpha, as we already said, and React DOM as well of the next version. Also, let's install Babel preset env and Babel preset React, as we need to compile our React code to S5. And I think it's all. Let's wait a bit till it installs. So it's installed, and now let's create two files. We don't need any build config because we're gonna use parcel to simplify the demo. So let's create two files, index.html and index.js. Okay, so we've created two files. Here let's do some basic layout. Let's call it hooks demo. And here we're saving index.js file and including this JavaScript here as a script. Ytab or script search C index.js. Okay. Saving it. Let's see if it works. Let's run parcel. Okay. Yeah, it works. So now let's add some boilerplate React code. Let's write some simple function component. By the way, we're gonna use the name function component and not the name stateless component, because now with the introduction of hooks, there are no more stateless component, because we can use, for example, use state hook and share state between function component, so it's now just plain function component. So let's import React and component as well. Also React DOM, of course. Uh, here let's write some plain app function, which is the root of our component. So let's just not use some hooks, just return node.view div. Okay, it's React JavaScript. Now it works. Yep. So here let's just create some text and let's implement a simple counter. For example, here will be our state variable and here will be our button. Please click me. So that's pretty it. And let's render it. Render app. Okay. Self-closing, let it be. Self-closing tag, document query selector. And let it be mounted in main tag as usual for me. Here is our main tag. Saving. Okay, let's see what our console says. Count is undefined, of course, because we have no state for now. Just you click times, let it be. Okay. It works. So now let's use the first basic hook of React library is called useState. So all the hooks start with use word, so you can easily distinguish them from other tools and methods. So all the hooks share pretty same syntax. So in order to use it, you in terms of, for example, use state, there are array destructions with two arguments. First argument is state itself, you can name it as you want. It will be count in our example, like in the example of the React tutorial. And second argument is a function which modifies this state. So let it be useCount. Or not useCount because it's the name of our hook, let it be setCount because we are setting this state. useState. And in the first argument of this function, there will be initial state, like let it be zero. And now we just defined this state variable and we can use it in our G6 as is. So you click count times, let's save it and see if it works. Yeah, you can see you click zero times. Our button still doesn't work. Let's add some logic here. Let's just add simple onClick listener here. And here we use G6 notation and pass here setCount method and modify the state here. Saving it, clicking it, and it works. So we can see we implemented a local state for our component which persists between renders, and this is plain old styled stateless component, but now just function component without class syntax, without any hooks, lifecycle methods. So we're just using React hooks here, and we can easily implement a state if we want. And we don't, if we for example have some stateless component, we need to add some state to it, we don't have to rewrite it as a class component. Now we just can use hooks and hook into this company and the, its methods and add, for example, a state. But this is not the only hook React provides. There is also a nice hook called useEffect. And this hook can modify, so it actually works as component did mount, component did update, and component will unmount methods, so lifecycle methods. So it's like combined hook for implementing these methods on function components. So in order to use it, you should provide a function inside this useEffect handler. And here we can modify the state, for example, we can perform any side effects of these components we want. For example, we can modify title of the document itself. So document title, hey DevTrends. Let's set it as this. And you can see our title has changed. So all side effects should be put in useEffect hook. And moreover, you can even use your local state here. So we can just put here clicked on button count times, saving it. And you can see there are title, new title of the document. And when we click in this button, you can see title is changing every time we click a button. So this is a pretty great functionality for new React. And moreover, this state doesn't have to be an object like this state in class components. You can see that you can use simple numbers, strings, even object arrays, whenever you want, and it will still work properly. So React hooks are a great new way to share common logic without writing excessive code and rewriting your components. It opens a whole world of possibilities to hook into React application logic and modify it as we wish with minimal overhead. And now let's move to HTTP version 3. So current modern standard of communication between client and server is HTTP version 2. Most applications and websites still use HTTP version 1 or 1.1 to be precise and feel pretty comfortable with it. But progress doesn't stand still, and recently new specification of HTTP number 3 has been standardized. Its more precise name is HTTP over Quick. And Quick is itself a new protocol which abbreviation stands for Quick UDP Internet Connections. This protocol was first started as an effort by Google and then was standardized as HTTP3 by Internet Engineering Task Force. So Quick is more robust and faster protocol than TCP. Actually, Quick is based on UDP, which itself light and quick but much less reliable than TCP. But Quick will handle packet losses itself, so with it, we should see big speed improvements over the old standard. And also, if a client blocks UDP, Quick can fall back to TCP and act as usual. HTTP3 proposal was published in October 24, which means it will take some time to finalize the specification and much more time to adapt it by actual implementators. That's all for today, folks. All the links are in the description below. Thank you for watching and stay trendy.